Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Do you really understand China? In fact, most people around the world can't fully explain how China transformed so dramatically in just a few decades. In this video, we'll walk you through a series of landmark engineering projects that reshaped the country. Projects that show how China rose from near nothing to global prominence. Ready? Let's go. Have you ever seen a map of China like this? High up in the sky, the elaborate network of atmospheric circulation delivers water vapor from the four oceans continuously into China, like rivers in the sky. They descend to Earth and become the 45,000 rivers that run and rush across the nation, bestowing China with one of the most dense river systems and the most diverse landscapes in the world. Let us begin with the Yangtze River, China's longest and also the largest by volume and watershed area. Its annual runoff accounts for 36% of China's grand total, equivalent to that of 17 Yellow Rivers combined. During flood seasons, the maximum runoff can triple its normal. If this imposing volume of water is not handled properly, a catastrophe awaits. If only there were an enormous pond that could store all the flood water. There it is. What you see now is the largest reservoir ever built in China, the Three Gorges Reservoir. The Three Gorges Project is one of the world's largest water control systems, about 2,335 meters long and 181 meters high. It integrates flood control, power generation, and navigation. It can store enormous flood volumes, supplies world-scale hydropower capacity, and lowers the difficulty and cost of shipping on the Yangtze. The project has sparked debate over resettlement and environmental impacts, but its strategic role in flood mitigation and energy security is substantial. With a storage capacity of up to 45 billion cubic meters, it can swallow more than 3,000 West Lakes, but this is still not sufficient. When you look at the entire Yangtze River, you will see in the upper mainstream the four cascade reservoirs known as Zhangjiaba, Siluodu, Baihetan, and Wudongde, and Tingziku, Gupitan, Ertan, and Jinping in the tributaries. Over 50 large reservoirs now guard the Yangtze watershed. In terms of water storage capacity, we have virtually built three more Three Gorges Reservoir. Every year before the flood season arrives, reservoirs empty part of their storage in preparation. The emptied volume is called the flood control capacity of a reservoir. When floods arrive, it is used to retain excessive water behind the dams. This prevents flood peaks from hitting the downstream simultaneously and compounding the risk. Meanwhile, the retained flood water is released downstream in a managed way so that flood peaks are either reduced or delayed. This ensures safety in the downstream. The entire watershed is also under the surveillance of more than 30,000 monitoring stations and meteorological satellites that relay precipitation and water level data in real time. They provide scientists with precise rainfall and flood data, which enable unified scheduling of the reservoir cluster. The South-to-North Water Diversion Project is China's largest water transfer undertaking, divided into eastern, central, and western routes. The central route starts at the Danjiangku Reservoir and runs about 1,432 kilometers through Henan and Hebei to Beijing. Rather than simply pumping water uphill, the project uses gravity-assisted channels, aqueducts, and tunnels to move southern water north. Completed over many years and involving the relocation of hundreds of thousands, the central route has delivered hundreds of billions of cubic meters of water by 2023, serving well over 100 million people and securing water supply for northern China. That equipped the entire route, this grand project is able to navigate through eight provinces and four major river basins, diverting water over 2,000 kilometers cumulatively in an orderly manner. 9 years into its full operation, water sufficient to fill up the entire Yellow River has been diverted to North China, meaning that 170 million people in 44 cities now use water from the Yangtze River. Today, empowered by modern technologies, China is reshaping rivers like never before, and even create new rivers on this very ancient land. This is the Taihong Mountains. Hanging along the cliffs are not just roads, but also a river. It is the Hongxi Canal that diverts water to Linzhou in Henan Province. Chronic droughts pushed the Linzhou people to hammer and carve this 70-kilometer-long waterway up high with bare hands and very basic tools. But 70 kilometers, it is barely a dot on the vast expanse of China. The temporary reservoir you see now are all man-made. China has more abundant water resources during summertime, and the vast of them belong to the southern regions. These artificial rivers are designed to break this extremely uneven distribution and restructure water allocation in China. Yet, creating artificial rivers puts man at the trying test of nature. In Shaanxi province, a 98-kilometer-long tunnel penetrates the Qinling Mountains and diverts water from the Hanzhong River to the densely populated Guangdong Plain. In Gansu province, water from the Yellow River traverses the desert, nourishing a string of oasis cities and resisting the expanding desert. The Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge spans roughly 55 kilometers and links Hong Kong, Zhuhai, and Macau. It's a highly complex maritime project that combines bridges, artificial islands, and an immersed tunnel to protect shipping lanes and sensitive ecological zones. Gigantic immersed tunnels were precisely installed with millimeter-level alignment, and the project used hundreds of thousands of tons of steel. Once opened, travel times between the cities dropped from hours to mere minutes, greatly advancing regional integration. China's high-speed rail network leads the world in scale and density, with over 40,000 kilometers of lines linking major cities into a high-speed web. With 40,000 kilometers of operating lines, far exceeding the total high-speed rail mileage of all other countries combined, this network tightly links more than 100 cities, serving a population of over 1 billion. Every year, it connects trillions of dollars in economic activity. Trains such as the Daxing operate at several hundred kilometers per hour with remarkable stability, punctuality, and comfort. From ice-covered plateaus to tropical islands, this vast network operates at high speed every single day. And thanks to China's efficient, rapid construction capabilities, it is constantly expanding. This is one of the most ambitious mega-projects ever undertaken by the Chinese people. And it's not the end, but just the beginning. Even more importantly, the core technologies of high-speed rail have been fully developed and industrialized domestically. China's standards and equipment are now being exported abroad, playing a growing role in high-speed rail projects worldwide. The Sichuan-Tibet Railway crosses high plateaus and active fault zones, one of the planet's most challenging rail routes. It traverses snow peaks, deep gorges, and unstable geology, confronting high altitude, thin air, and extreme weather. Construction required precise tunnel boring, aerial bridge assembly, and plateau-specific techniques. Landmark structures like the Yarlung Zhangbo River Bridge were erected with helicopter lifts and millimeter precision steel assembly. Beyond connectivity, the line carries strategic and vital civilian importance. Starting from Tiananmen Square and moving 46 kilometers south along Beijing's central axis, a brand new world-class landmark has risen, the Beijing Daxing International Airport. Together with Capital International Airport, it forms a dual hub system, providing powerful support for the coordinated development of the Beijing-Tianjin-Hebei region. From a mega engineering project to China's new national gateway, Daxing Airport has always been in the global spotlight. In 2016, it was named the number one of the seven new wonders of the world by The Guardian. The terminal complex covers an astonishing 1.4 million square meters, equivalent to 3.2 Tiananmen Squares. Today, it has become one of the largest aviation hubs on the planet. Beijing Daxing International Airport, shaped like a phoenix, features an enormous single terminal designed for efficiency and passenger convenience. Seen from the sky, this airport is already breathtaking. The entire terminal radiates outward in five concourses, resembling a phoenix spreading its wings. With a total floor area of 1.4 million square meters, equivalent to 63 bird's nest stadiums, it is one of the largest single-structure terminals in the world. Its main roof is made up of more than 8,000 irregular curved glass panels, a construction challenge that was nothing short of hell level in the world of architecture. But what's truly remarkable is its efficiency and design philosophy. From security to the farthest boarding gate takes only 8 minutes on foot. It is also the world's first integrated transportation hub, combining high-speed rail, metro, intercity rail, and express lines all beneath one roof. Add to that a fully automated baggage system, intelligent navigation, paperless boarding, and facial recognition, and passengers here hardly feel the wait at all. One detail during construction left a lasting impression. The central hall ceiling houses a dome of light, illuminated entirely by natural sunlight during the day, both energy-saving and visually stunning. Installing this dome was an extreme engineering challenge. Workers stood on scaffolding dozens of meters high, piecing it together millimeter by millimeter. And yet, the entire civil construction of the airport took only 4 years, a feat hailed globally as a miracle of Chinese speed. With its completion, Beijing entered the era of dual airports, boosting its annual passenger capacity to 100 million. More than just an airport, this is a super gateway connecting China to the world and a powerful symbol of China's modernization. To bridge spatial gaps between energy resources and demand, China built UHV transmission lines that move large amounts of clean power over great distances. Projects such as the Changji-Guquan 1,100 kilovolt DC line span thousands of kilometers and transmit tens of billions of kilowatt hours annually. With tens of thousands of kilometers of UHV lines, China now networks wind, solar, and hydro generation into major eastern population centers. Beidou is China's independently developed global navigation satellite system. From its inception in 1994 to global coverage in 2020, Beidou now operates dozens of satellites worldwide. In many scenarios, it outperforms standard civilian GPS with meter level and in some cases centimeter level accuracy. It also supports short message services, precision timing, and global search and rescue. Beidou has proven critical in rescue missions and industrial applications, is part of international GNSS interoperability frameworks, and is increasingly offering services globally. In the future, every frontier of technology, autonomous driving, the Internet of Things, smart cities, intelligent manufacturing, and civil-military integration will rely on pinpoint positioning, flawless timing, and unshakable navigation. At the heart of it all will be Beidou. High above us, across the boundless expanse of space, it has woven a precise and intricate web of stars, linking Earth to the heavens with invisible threads of light. Beidou is more than a triumph of engineering. It is a gift from Eastern civilization to this era, a coordinate in time and space that will guide the world into the future. In the digital age, 5G base stations, data centers, and the national internet backbone are the new infrastructure. China rapidly deployed millions of 5G sites, rolled out East Compute, West Store, and scaled IPv6 adoption. This digital backbone supports autonomous vehicles, industrial IoT, smart cities, and digital payments, an invisible but critical network that powers modern life. When you think of a desert, what comes to your mind? Endless sand? Scorching heat? No signs of life? Well, where deserts are not dying, the Taklimakan Desert, China's largest desert. For decades, its sands crept outward. Homes, roads, farmland, all lost to the wind. That story is changing. After 40 years of effort, China has built a 3,046-kilometer greenbelt encircling the desert, the longest man-made desert shield on Earth. It doesn't just stop sand, it's helping lift people out of poverty. So how did they do it? First came the basics: roads, irrigation systems, power grids. In 2024 alone, billions were invested in Xinjiang's desert control. Then came three models. Model 1, engineering. Lattices of straw checkerboards are laid across the dunes. They break the wind, slow the sand. On the edges of the Taklimakan Desert in Bachu County, factories produce reed mats in weaving machines, a faster process and a more durable product, and a new income stream for locals who install them. Model 2, biology. Drought-resistant plants take root in the sand, and hidden beneath some, a desert herb called Cistanchi deserticola, nicknamed the ginseng of the desert. To grow the herb, you must grow the sand-fixing plants first. Ecology and economy intertwine. To scale this up, the government offered incentives for companies and farmers to lease desert land, turn it into farmland, and grow sustainable industries. Model 3, solar power. This desert gets endless sun, which is perfect for solar farms. In Shea County, 540,000 solar panels generate clean power, enough for the needs of 430,000 people a year, while anchoring the ground against erosion. Some regions have gone further by turning the desert into a destination. Macau County saw 500,000 tourists last year, creating jobs and boosting the local economy. And this is just the beginning. By 2030, Xinjiang plans to restore even more arid land and build a full industry loop, linking solar power, eco-agriculture, and desert tourism. The projected annual value? Over $1.4 billion. Over the past four decades, generations of desert fighters in China have discovered a powerful truth, that within the shifting sands lies a path, from retreat to resistance and revival. The Three North Shelter Belt program began in 1978 and is one of China's largest longest-running ecological restoration efforts. Aimed at halting desertification and protecting farmland, it has planted billions of trees and restored tens of millions of hectares, taming sandstorms and transforming regions over generations. Its value is quiet but profound: ecological security and improved quality of life. Beyond the projects above, China has world-class achievements in energy and science. For example, the Baihetan Hydropower Station is among the most complex hydropower hubs, with massive generating units manufactured and installed to micro and submillimeter tolerances, showcasing expertise in large-scale precision machinery. And FAST, the 500-meter aperture spherical telescope, sits in a karst sink and offers sensitivity multiple times that of earlier giant telescopes, used for exoplanet searches, pulsar studies, and dark matter research. Together, they illustrate China's integrated strength across energy, science, and infrastructure. These projects are no accident. They combine national planning, large engineering workforces, integrated supply chains, and sustained R&D. Unlike countries that stall on approvals, financing, or local disputes, China's system can concentrate resources and execute major projects quickly. China now exports this capability through overseas contracting and cooperation, reshaping parts of the global infrastructure landscape. Infrastructure is more than steel and concrete. It underpins national competitiveness, improves everyday life, and invests in the future. Over recent decades, China's engineering projects have reshaped geography, sped up economies, and broadened social possibilities. Whatever your view, these projects are impacting the world in unprecedented ways. Tell us in the comments which projects surprised you most and what future feats you expect. If you enjoyed this deep dive, like, subscribe, and share. See you next time. Thanks for watching.